Today I went out to do some autumn close-up photography, and in this video I want to share my absolutely best tips for this kind of photography. So without further ado, let's get into it. First of all, I recommend you to get a lens that is either a macro lens or a portrait lens with a wide max aperture. Today I used my Canon 5D Mark II, which is a pretty old camera, and the legendary portrait lens Canon 135mm f2, which has incredibly nice and smooth bokeh, and also it can focus pretty closely, which is important for what we're about to do in this video. Tip number two is to find not only an interesting subject, in my case here a rosehip, but also find an angle where you have a background that is also interesting. Here you can see just a rosehip without no particular background at all, and the picture looks okay but not super interesting. But if you can find a background, find an angle where you have maybe some other rosehips in the background or something else that is colorful, that harmonizes or maybe contrasts with your main subject, that will make the whole picture a lot more interesting. Look here for example. Here I've included some other rosehips in the background, and now you can see that the bokeh is a hell of a lot more interesting. And often you can accomplish this by just tweaking the angle a bit so that the background complements your main subject. The weather today was very grey, dull and boring and almost dark. But the nice thing with close-up photography is that usually you can actually take pretty nice photos despite the weather being shit. And this is one of the things I really like about close-up and macro photography, that you can basically go out in any weather, and even though maybe it would have been nicer with some sun, you can actually take some nice photos even in this grey and dark weather. Tip number three for taking nice autumn close-ups is to look around a lot in the viewfinder. Make it a habit to always be looking through your viewfinder, even though you're not seeing anything that you think will become a nice picture, because very often by looking through the viewfinder a lot you will find these nice compositions that you didn't even know existed by just looking with your eyes. This is something that is special for close-up and macro photography, that you cannot really envision how a picture would look unless you actually look in the viewfinder. So do this a lot. One thing that I find very enjoyable with photo walks, such as the one I did today, where I was out walking for like 2 hours with my camera, is that you easily come into like a meditative state where you're in flow and you're in the moment. And that is because you're constantly looking for nice photos to take. You're constantly observing your environment, and therefore you kind of force yourself to be in the moment all the time. And I think bringing a camera to a walk in nature really does something. You actually enjoy it a lot more because you're constantly looking for the beauty all around you. My next and perhaps the best tip for stunning autumn photography close-ups is to use the white balance slider when you get home and start editing your photos. When you photograph yellow and bluish things, as you often do in the autumn, very often the white balance in your camera kind of gets it wrong. And even if it gets it right, just by pushing the white balance slider to the yellow side, as I did here, you can see what a difference it makes. All of a sudden this really feels like an autumn photo, which it did not really do before editing it. So push the white balance slider a bit more to the right, maybe a bit, even a bit more than it looked in real life, and you will get beautiful autumn colors. My next tip is to be really mindful about the edges in your photo. Look here, a slightly different composition than the one before, and you see this little branch sticking in from the right, completely upsetting the whole picture and destroying the harmony. And of course you can in some cases edit these things out, but it's a lot easier to just make the composition right from the beginning. Make it a habit to look in your corners and to the sides of your frame, and make sure that you don't have stuff sticking out there, destroying the harmony of the photo. Almost all of the shots in this video were taken at an aperture of f2. And the reason for this is both because I really enjoy the bokeh that my 135mm lens produces at this aperture, but also because it was a pretty dark day and I needed all the light I could get, especially in the forest, so therefore I shot at max aperture. Most of the photos in this video were shot as closely as I could on the minimum focusing distance, and in the case of my 135mm f2 lens from Canon, I think it has a magnification ratio of 0.2, which is pretty good for a portrait lens, for a non-macro lens, and for photographing leaves and stuff it is definitely enough. Another thing that can be very, very pretty when you're shooting a picture along a fence or along a branch or something is to make the fence or the branch disappear in the background. This gradual blurriness that increases the further back you go usually makes for very beautiful photos, so it's a nice little trick to use now and then. Some of the best autumn days to go out to do close-up photography is usually when you see a lot of leaves swirling around and dropping from trees, because on these days there will be a lot of freshly fallen leaves all around you, and you can photograph them and they will look nice, no one will have stepped on them or anything, and that makes for the best days to do autumn photography. But on the other hand, on days like this one, when I went out today, it was not windy at all, and it was very nice because then it is a lot easier to photograph leaves because they are still. That's it for this little video. Please give me a like if you did like it. And don't forget to subscribe to my photography email newsletter. It's completely free, it comes out once a month, and it contains my best tips and inspiration and gear tips and other stuff that I didn't include in any of my YouTube videos during the month. Sign up at mwroll.com. And please subscribe to this channel if you like this video. I post similar videos once a week, at least I try to. And also, if you feel like it, please go visit me on Instagram. My name there is mwroll. That's it for this video. Thank you for watching. See you soon again. Over and out. Bye.